All right, I want to do a quick video of the behind the scenes of the bird feeder live stream. You get a lot of folks thinking I'm out in the country, like way out in the middle of nowhere. That's not the case. I'm in a subdivision. So I'm going to kind of show you what's around and just to show you that, you know, regardless of where you live, you can feed the birds and enjoy doing it. This is what my bird feeder looks like from my kitchen window. So we can see the bird feeder when we're eating supper, which is pretty neat. Here's Violet working on her chalk bird in the driveway. Good job, Violet.
Hi.
she's giving it, what is it, a cardinal?
Yes.
You're putting the tuft on its head there. Smart. She's hoping this will attract more birds. So if you walk out my back door, you can see the bird feeder right there. It's right outside. We walk up these steps and we're there. So it's real close to the house and the swimming pool and this row of Carolina jasmine that I have growing on the chain link fence, which a lot of the birds love to hide in between visits to the feeder. So this, you can see the camera there on the far left. And this is the setup. It's nothing fancy. It's just a couple poles in the ground. Got my squirrel baffles to keep the squirrels out. We've got our millworms, little bird bath, and the feeding platform, which is probably about 3 foot by a foot and a half, maybe 4 feet. There's the little heart we made. And there's the camera. This is a just a regular old IP camera. So it's like a security camera that's wired with a Cat5 cable. I had to cut that little bowl and put it on the edge to try and keep some of the water off when it rains. I was having issues with that. But that's what the setup looks like. And as you can see, I've got a row of green giant arborvitae that run across the back of the property, and then my backyard goes down through here. This area that looks like it's cut out, I planted with wildflower seeds this winter. So I'm hopeful those will be blooming here later this spring and summer. It's my neighbor's house, and there's a view back of my house and what the bird feeder looks like. And then going around, there's my driveway, and there's my ladder I use to change out the bird seed, my woodshed, and some swings and such. So I'm not out in the middle of nowhere. I do have a lot of cover for the birds, which is nice. So that up there's the feeder. There comes Violet. She's finished with her bird. But I'm showing everybody the blueberry bushes, Violet. So I've got a bunch of blueberry bushes over there. These are all blackberry and raspberry vines that grow up here in the summer. So we get quite a bit of birds eating those. And then I've got a nice little brush pile over here that I had really always been thinking about getting rid of. But now that I've got this giant bird feeder, I notice a lot of the birds head over to this area after they grab seeds. So I think this is a pretty good habitat. There's actually one in that tree right there right now, but that's a eastern red cedar right there. And then these are all the green giant arborvitaes I put in for a screen. But and then there's the brush pile, which I know we have some rabbits living in there. I think there's some birds in there too. Here are the little blueberry bushes I was talking about. We just planted those during COVID. We went crazy and planted I think 16, and I think they're supposed to produce like 25 pounds of blueberries a piece, so we might be in trouble once they grow and get mature. But they're starting to bud. So here's our compost pile. I had mentioned on our chat on the live stream that I put a camera here, and I did. There it is. I've got a wildlife camera that I'm tracking the wildlife that comes and visits the compost pile. So I need to get in there and mix that up. I haven't mixed it in a few months, but hopefully that'll help us out with our raised bed gardens this year. And you can, as you can see, right over those jasmine vines is where the bird feeder is. So we're real close there.
Yeah, Violet, we're around the front of the house, but Violet and her friend built this secret hideout in between all of our bushes. Just a hideout.
Yeah, so anyway, she wanted me to show that on the video. Okay, she finished the bird. It's a nice bird. She made a sign to go with it.
Bird lovers.
That's right. We love birds. All right. Thank you, Violet. That's a great bird. All right. So, yeah. All right. So, that's it. That's kind of the behind the scenes of the bird feeding station live stream. Just wanted to show you all what I got going on. It's actually pretty basic. So, you just need you somewhere to put some bird seed. You could do that on anything. It doesn't really matter, and it doesn't matter if you're in a neighborhood or out in the middle of the country. You can do it there too. So appreciate your time, and you can check out the live stream. I'll put a link in the description and see what it looks like. Y'all take care.